piece of my social media handles and all the links are down below in the description box. What's wrong? Hey, shh, shh, shh. Come on. What's wrong? Come on. Why are you crying? Why are you crying? What's wrong? Come on, you can tell me. I'm a doctor. I'm the doctor. I'm not the doctor. I'm just a doctor. I'm a medical professional. Tell me your woes. What's wrong? What's wrong? Go on. Oh, right. Okay. Right, yeah. Okay, that's not some... That's not great news to receive. Shh. Shh. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. Just sit down, take a seat. Let's calm you down, okay? Dry your eyes, where are you? Use this, dry your eyes, go on. Just step. There you go, there you go. Hey, shh, it's okay. It's okay, shh. Right, who have you just been with? Dr. Radcliffe. Right, okay, I see now where the problem is. And what's he told you? Right, okay, certainly. Let's work through this, shall we? Just allow me just to calm you down, okay? Okay, what I want you to do is put a finger to your lips, like so. One finger to both lips, okay? Shh. And now breathe in through your nose. Keep that finger still. Like that. Shh. Keep that finger still and breathe in through your nose. Keep your mouth and lips shut. Breathing in only through your nose and breathing out through your nose. Breathing in through your nose, breathing out through your nose. Let's calm down, okay? If you just close your eyes for me, I'm just going to brush your face ever so gently. Ever so gently, I'm going to brush your face. Shh. Shh. Let's brush away those worries. Brush away those worries. Okay. Side, from side to up to down to side, side to up, down to side. Okay. Now, what I want you to do is just hold my hands and we're going to focus on each other's breathing, okay? You breathe when I breathe and I breathe. You breathe when I breathe when you breathe, okay? So. So, what was it that Dr. Radcliffe has diagnosed you with? I know you've said he's told you that there's something going incredibly wrong, but you weren't too specific. Shh, it's okay. I don't mean to bring up any wounds or anything. It's okay. You don't have to tell me if you don't want to. If you don't want to. If you don't want to. Right, okay. So, what we can do, now that you've calmed down just a little bit, I'm going to keep trying to chill you out the best way I know how and the most legal way that I know how. So, do you see inside this box? It's empty. I put it back in. Just slots right in. And if you give it a feel, it's super soft. It's lovely, isn't it? Okay. I just wanted to show you it. A bottle of some secret lotion. It's got the child lock on it, so I do struggle getting in sometimes, I'll be honest. Oh, you can open it. Give it a go. It's quite difficult, actually. Not so easy, is it? But inside are this bottle. Have a sip of this magic potion. Okay, here you go. And drink up. Just a little sip is all you need, maybe 5 or 10 milliliters. It's got a little bit of syrup in it. Delicious. Very minty, almost like a eucalyptus. Like it tastes like how eucalyptus smells. I always do that, I always describe things the way something else smells, you know? Like marzipan tastes like how petrol smells, I think. I don't like marzipan though, if I'm honest. Okay. So that should take like 5 or 10 minutes to work. It actually turns into something else in your stomach. The enzymes in your stomach work to build this lovely sort of relaxing chemical and spreads throughout your body. What I want to do until it kicks in, though, you may feel slightly drowsy, but that's totally fine. I'm just going to have a little look at what Dr. Radcliffe has said and make sure that, you know, they're on the right track. Because Dr. Radcliffe has got so much stuff wrong in his time here. He's only been here like 4 or 5 hours. Yeah, he's already made 4 misdiagnoses. some of these worries. Plug, throw away. See? Plug, throw away. Plug, throw away. Plug, throw away. Keep doing this. See, they're just useless worries. Get rid of them. You don't need them. All they do is weigh you down. There's a little quote often attributed to the Dalai Lama, the one that's alive right now. And he says, you know, why worry? Why stress? If you can change something, change it. If you can't change something, well, then it's out of your control. And worrying's not going to help the situation, it's just going to make you feel worse. It's hard oftentimes to put it into practice, you know? Like a lot of good advice, you know, it's very hard to actually, you know, do it and allow it to seep into your consciousness. But once you do, it really is quite valuable. Brush this face one more time. Up, 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 down, 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 up, 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 down, 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 side, 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 side. Lovely. Okay. Now, if you don't mind, I've got some lotion here. And now, whilst waiting for my little potion to start working its magic, gloves on, but give it a whiff, give it a whiff, give it a strawberry, quite nice. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this all over your face, just lather it on, lather it on, lather it on, okay? And you're going to find that your skin starts to feel like it's no longer really part of your face, and your face has been sort of replaced, as it is, with felt and velvet and the stars and all sorts of lovely ethereal things. How are you feeling? You feeling a bit better? That's much better, thank you. Good, good, I'm glad. It shouldn't be much longer until you feel entirely at peace and relaxed. I'm just going to double check, okay? I just want to double check something. I'm just going to take these off as well. And these can actually go with your worries in the bin or over there on Dr. Radcliffe's desk. Because we share an office sometimes, All right, I'll put this back on as well. So, let's have a look just quickly. Can you open one of your eyes, please? Thank you. Okay, the other one. Open your mouth, please. If you could just pull this side of your face down and keep the other side entirely still. Can you just expose your forehead for me? Okay. Seems interesting, you know. I feel like he has made another misdiagnosis. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have you come in tomorrow. I know, I'm sorry. I know it's not ideal, especially during the current, you know, pandemic and everything. But if you come in tomorrow, and I'll schedule in with Dr. Villarreal, if that's okay. Now, she is fantastic. Probably the best doctor in this clinic. Yeah. I mean, yeah, you're very kind, but I'm not a very good doctor. Yeah, I'm quite easygoing and calm you down, but you asked me what a hematoma is. I don't know. Is it an extremity on the foot of a mother? A toma? That's silly. But yeah, so I'll schedule in with Dr. Valerio. She's fantastic, as I said. And I'm going to get her to have just a second look at you, because it's, you know, false negatives are a thing, false positives are a thing. And, yeah, I'm sure that you're going to get a different diagnosis. Unfortunately, I haven't got enough time right now to do it myself, otherwise I would. And I'm really sorry that I haven't, but I do hope you're feeling a lot calmer now, a lot more chilled out, and you can see things from a sort of second perspective, as it is. Certainly, it's always good to sort of, you know, especially when we're in a state of worry, to just take a step back and think, right, well, yeah, okay, let's look at this logically, like, gives you that clearer eyesight almost. Yeah, and you can sort of see things like, ah, right, like, say there's a dog, not a dog, let's say a human. A human's right up in your face, really angry, shouting you, like this, they're like this close from you. Now, usually a lot of people would sort of be paralyzed with fear and be like, what do I, you know, they wouldn't really know how to react. But suddenly, if your eyesight clears, you can realize, oh, they're ages away from, you know, they're this far from me. I can just step to the side. That was my chair. I saw you thinking, you're like, what was that noise? What was that noise that just happened? It was my chair. I honestly was my chair. Stop, I'll kick you out. So yeah, so it's like that. If someone's up close to you and, you know, you have that clear eyesight, suddenly you're like, ah, well, there's the answer. You know, you're not just frozen, your mind's not blank, and you can think properly. So yeah, I hope you're feeling a bit better, and come in tomorrow. I'll see you tomorrow as well. I'll say hi and everything, and Dr. Valerial will sort things out for you. All right, take care, have a safe journey home, sleep well, I'll see you tomorrow.